Good morning, children. Good morning, Makra. How are you all? Fine? Okay. So, in the last class, we started the lesson that was an unusual birthday present. An unusual birthday present. Who was given this? This was given by Jawaharlal Nehru, our first Prime Minister, to his daughter. Who was his daughter? His daughter's name was Priyadarshini Gandhi, means Indira Gandhi, Priyadarshini Indira Gandhi. When he was in the jail, he wrote a letter to Indira Gandhi. Indira, after the marriage, she became Indira Gandhi. Okay, so he wrote a letter to Indira on the occasion of her birthday. Because on her every birthday, she had a habit of receiving big or wonderful gifts by her father. Her father used to give unusual or different types of gifts to her. But this time he was in the jail. So he is writing this letter as a gift to his daughter Indira. Okay, he started the letter as "My dear Indira." Before writing the letter, we also have learned to write the letters, right? How to write? When we are writing our letters to our relatives, they are called informal letters. They are called as informal letters, and they will start with our name, from where we are writing, right? And then whom we are writing, that all will be there. So, "My dear Indira, on your birthday, you have been in the habit of receiving gifts, presents and good wishes." She had a habit of receiving good presents and good wishes. But this time, he was helpless because he was in the jail in the Naini. He was in the central jail in the Naini. So he says, "This time I am away from you, so I cannot give you any different present. So I am thinking to send a letter as a gift. So this will be a best ode, means it will bring a big, it is a biggest gift in your life from your papa, a father," he says. Okay, and what else he writes in that? Just a minute, children. Never be bored or imagine. Never you get bored or imagine to be bored. But the very foolish and consistent person whose story Huynh's Tank has told us. Huynh's Tank, I told you in the last class, Huynh's Tank was boring, but he was writing. So he was written so many good things about our country. He was a visitor from China. Who wrote about the glory of our India, of our country. He wrote about our glory of our country. He was from China. And perhaps it is as well that we do not become very wise for the very wise. If any such, there are, must sometimes feel rather sad. There is nothing more to learn. When we feel bored or sad, what we should do to come out from that, we should learn to read. That is the best way. Who says this? The Jawaharlal Nehru, first Prime Minister of our country, tells to his daughter in the birthday wishes letter. Whenever you feel bored or tired, sad, you learn to read. That is the best habit. They must miss the joy of discovery and of learning new things. The great adventures that all of us who care to may have. And when you read, you may read or you may discover the joy of learning new things. When we read, we learn many new things, right? Now, we are being at home. you what you all are doing, how you all are spending your time? By reading or watching TV? By reading, right? Sometimes you watch TV, but sometimes what you all have to do? You all have to read. That will give you more knowledge. That will give you more knowledge. Then it is not said by Jawaharlal Nehru. It is I am telling you what he told his daughter. When you read, you may miss the joy of discovery and joy of learning new things. The great adventure that all of us who care to may have. We all want to have different, or we all have want to go for different adventures. We want to go in the forest. We want to go near the water, right? We want to swim in the water like fish. We want to fly in the air like bird. We have so many dreams. We want to do so many things. We want to achieve so many things. But when it is going to possible? When we read. And then I must not therefore sermonize, but what I am to do then? He is saying, I may not be there with you all the time, but what am I do then? What will I do if I am not there with you to support you? What will I do? He says, a letter can hardly take the place of talk. At best, it is a one-sided affair. So if I say anything that sounds like good advice, do not take it as if it were a bad pill to swallow. See, when I am writing this letter, it is like one-sided discussion, because I am only speaking here. Because when we write a letter, the writer only becomes the speaker. The other person, means the person who is reading, he will be the only listener or audience, right? We can call him as an audience or listener. So don't feel bored to read this letter, or it may sound that like good advice. Do not take it as if it is were a bad pill to swallow. He says, if it may sound good to read, and you may feel bored also to read, but don't read it as a bad pill to swallow. Pill means tablet. When we fall sick, what we take the medicine, they are called as pills. So he says, when you are reading this letter, it may be one-sided affair, means one-sided speaking. A person only speaking, you are just listening. So you may feel bored, but please don't take it as a bad pill to swallow. Means kelo sala namge hushar illadag en agutte medicine doctor medicine kodirtar avag tagolvaga en anusute yappa gestu bejaru ondara vasne ide idu hangide hingide. So many complaints we will have, right? So her father says, don't take this letter as a bad pill to swallow. Means idina nungodakke kashta patkondu nungo thara odbeda. If you like it, you read it. What he says, if you like it, you read it. Okay, children, we continue in the next class. What is your work? You have to read the lesson. Okay, take care.